the price action is very interesting over here. We are holding this support with a strong bullish candle. This candle ended up passing the high up here. We thought we were going to continue right back up and at least like maybe reach this area and then retrace a little bit to then continue right back up. But nonetheless, we kept respecting the lower highs over here. So this area ended up getting rejected completely. Get these tools out. Where is it? Here we go. Yeah, this area has been rejected completely. 150-500 completely closing below every single time. Right over here. All these previous candles over here as well. So this candle, could we be holding support to continue right back up? I mean, I don't know about you, but those are some pretty bad numbers. So maybe we're just grabbing liquidity up here to then continue right back down, continue driving back down. Are we going to respect the high of this candle over here? That should be interesting, where we end up grabbing liquidity and then slowly start flipping bearish to continue right back down. I liked Gary's chart over there, but let's go over to the 4 hour. So the 4 hour, again, we're still creating these lower highs, lower lows. But right now we have a solid support over here from yesterday. 149,500 ended up holding a strong support over here, grabbed liquidity, and we ended up closing bullish. Now we're gradually starting to come up a little bit, but we have this area to worry about, to think about. I hate using that word, worry. So now we're kind of like stuck in here. We need to break above this level. We'll see what it looks like on the lower time frames, but let's actually get rid of some of this. So we need to like close above that level. And if we do, we could be coming up into this area. To grab liquidity. We fail to break right here. And then we continue right back down. We could get something like that. We could fail to break resistance right here, and we end up consolidating over here, and that's the rest of the week until maybe next week. Then we continue right back down. We could end up rejecting resistance right over here, break this little support right here, and then continue right back down to this level over here. So there's, you have multiple different things that could happen. We could break resistance, fake out and then continue down. We could also break resistance and then break that resistance to then continue right back up to these levels up here. But you have this move, you have this move right over here, and then you have that move. So multiple different options for you. The 1 hour. So the 1 hour right now, we are rejecting this level multiple times. We've already rejected over here as well, 150, 200, strong level over here. But we do have this support. But even if we break this support, it gets into some sticky area. The only thing is we know we're holding resistance and we should be continuing right back down to 149, 600, if that's the case. So let's see if we keep stalling in this area. You have the two EMAs here at the same spot as well. So let's see if we stall out over here and we start breaking this support. Again, holding a support right over here. If we break that resistance, you got a nice move. Actually, not too nice, but you could be coming up into 150,500, I would say. Fill this wick right over here, come into this area. Specifically, yeah, from 150, 250. Right up into at least get 18 pips coming into this resistance right over here. And then eventually probably like 20 pips going up to 500. Obviously 300 to 500, that's 20 pips. 200 pipettes. But other than that, just, you know, classic Friday where we're just kind of ranging. We could get that just, you know, dump off later during New York over here. But nonetheless, we are printing sideways, right? There's nothing really that is too appealing that you want to take. If you want to wait for levels to break, I would wait for the retest, and then you just trade accordingly. Trade smart. Make sure you're managing risk, but personally, it looks like at this point, I'd want to stay out of GJ just because of how messy this range is. Looking at gold over here, you know what? We're going back to light mode. I can't do it. That was pissing me off a little bit. I just wonder why it does that sometimes. All right, so we're breaking down over here on gold. So we may actually have a, hold on, let me bring this up. Okay, so looking over here at the new daily candle, we ended up grabbing liquidity and creating that top wick and then never passing the high of the previous and then passing the low of it right over here. So could we be continuing right back down to this level of 1762, 1760, this whole demand area that we've previously rejected multiple times? Could we be coming back down below that? So looking at the 4 hour right now, 4 hour, this is nicer price action than we've previously had. It's also better price action than GJ right now. So this could be our main pair that we're looking at for the day. See, we've been in this bearish trend, right? Kind of printing these lower lows, lower highs, but at the same time consolidating. But right now, we're respecting these lower highs and lower lows. Right over here, perfect formation, right? Break, consolidate, retest, creating that low. We come up, retest, and then we pass the low over here. So could we be coming up into this area over here to then retest that low and continue right back down to let's say 1762.50, right over here? We're starting to get into this area right here. You could see these wicks. You got that wick wicking into that area. Previous support over here. You technically just draw that as a zone right there, and that's what we're waiting for. That's what we're reacting to. This is the 4 hour too, so obviously this is a strong zone over here. You don't always have to draw it like that though. Let's look at the 1 hour. Yeah, 1 hour, we're getting into a heavy zone that we could end up rejecting. But like I said, if we come up right here and retest this area, this previous support, it's probably best not to counter trend trade on a Friday, but I could definitely see this coming up here and maybe grabbing like a buy coming up this way, but I wouldn't do it, not on a Friday. If it was Wednesday, you wait for some confirmations on these lower time frames, like the 30 minute. This actually might be a good play. I would wait for a support to form over here to then take price back up. But even this, I might stay out of as well. See, we just ended up clearing this consolidation with this candle. See, we have this whole consolidation right here. This candle just clears it. This candle looks like it's going to break the high of it. I'm waiting for a little retest over here so I don't buy the high. Wait for a better price to get in. And then you could take this thing right back up to this area. Or we could get a fake out right here and price closes right back into this range. And then we continue right back down. But I don't know if I would take that because this area is so strong. Gary, are you looking at anything similar? Let's see what you got for gold over here. So gold? No, this is GJ. So I'm not sure. Let's see. Maybe trend line could be this. I'd say this trend line might be correct, Gary. One. But at the same time, we continue to consolidate in here, right? See, we're still consolidating right now. Yeah, so yep, it's holding strong. So maybe it is this. But I wouldn't put too much stock in the trend lines. Obviously, you want to have the correct one. They're all subjective. But don't, like, overthink it. If you have to overthink it, I would just delete it and just focus on the levels. Does that make sense? Yeah, I think this might be the correct one. So this is a little rangy over here. Gary, you also have the one right here. Price keeps rejecting. So let's see what happens. But, you know, I'm not too enticed by GJ. Especially after not getting any good numbers coming out and nothing happening. And that's what we're really waiting for. Yeah, but wait for price to react to this level over here and wait for support. You want to know that this isn't going to be a fake out over here, especially in a bearish trend. You want to know that we're going to get some kind of solid support, candles closing in our direction, at least on the 15-minute, to then take price out. Because you could enter that buy up here and then just end up getting stopped right out. That would be a rookie mistake. And as we've learned from James's trade in the group Trello, you bought at the high up here, right? Instead of waiting for this little support. See, this could happen to us right now if we took that buy right now. And then price just starts rejecting, takes us out. And then guess what? It ends up doing what we said it would do, where it creates that support to continue up. You want to wait for some good confirmations on Friday. Like, your rules shouldn't change too much through, you know, day to day. But at the same time, when it comes to Friday, Monday, Sunday, you got to be a little bit more cautious. We actually have a new member, Catherine. We got another girl in here. I got to add her to everything right now. Okay, so that's clear. So that's it. That's it. You guys got anything planned for the weekend?
Nah, I don't got no plans, really.
No plans? You got, nope. No plans at all, huh?
If I just work. Just work.
Make some money. Back test.
Yeah, I'm going to have to add that to my schedule for sure. Because I ain't got no plans. So I will definitely back test because I need to.
Yeah, 100%. That's where the confidence comes from, buddy. Confidence comes from the back testing, like the preparation, and also knowing that you're trusting yourself to manage risk. Knowing that you'll cut your losses short and you won't hesitate at all. That doesn't mean micromanaging too much. You know, that balance comes over time. But the fact that you can trust yourself, and that's in any aspect of life, that's where the confidence is going to come. She's taken care of. So yeah, I would probably wait for a retest. Gary, you looking for the same thing? You get a strong support held right over here, could continue right back up to this level. Or right up here. So you should take a look at the dollar index. Dollar's holding support over here. We're also approaching this trend. We're holding a strong support on the dollar. Also, you know, with the fear of inflation, wow, would you look at that? With the fear of inflation and everything going around, the Omicron variant, stuff like that, when you have fear like that, normally gold should be bullish. But right now, gold is bearish, and there's multiple reasons for that. If you look at some of the Eastern nations like China, Australia, all these countries out there rely heavily on heavy metals, especially gold with Australia. So when those economies are not doing too well, these heavy metals aren't going to do too well either. China's definitely not doing well. You guys both watched that video yesterday about a crash is coming for China. Australia relies heavily on China. Also, Australia is in a crazy, ridiculous lockdown right now. So obviously, there's no growth, no production. So a lot of these countries that are relying on these metals, you know, they're going to get hit a little bit, or especially the metals are going to get hit. So let's see if this support holds. If that does happen, if we get like this bearish candle forming and then we get a bottom wick formed, never past the low, and then it passes the high right here, and we have volume coming in, might be able to take a nice impulse entry up. But I'd rather wait for candles to close in our direction. That'd be a quiet day for us today, huh? This candle's already trying to flip. See, the 1 hour candle just opened as well. So the 1 hour candle just created a bottom wick. Wow, these are two very healthy bullish candles as well. See, again, I want to take this trade, but I don't want to force it on a Friday. I don't want to force like an impulse entry. This candle is flipping bullish over here. Right in the beginning of, if it has the power to break the high up here, then we should be continuing up. Let me place these. See, I don't know if this is something I want to take. Just because of the range. Yeah, this is not that big of a range. I'd rather wait for a resistance to form over here to take this down. I'm not going to force this. This is kind of a emotional decision. If I were to take this, it looks like. It's what it feels like right now. So I'm going to hold myself back. If anything, I would have put my stop loss below probably this candle right over here. It's passing the high. We're just going to paper trade this one. Let's see how this works out. The only thing is, like, this is such a small range over here. It's only like 20 pips, 16 pips stop loss. You know, if you put your stop loss right there, that could work. But at the same time, it's gold. We could come right back down and stop us out. Let's paper trade this and see how it works out. And while that's going on, let me just use the bathroom real quick.
Hey, you're on mute.
Good call, bro. What's it called? It looks like we did get that push up over here, which is good. Gary, how's your setup right now? Need to sweat myself out with the working station, having to keep flickering between Zoom and the charts. What if you put Zoom on your phone? David, Stipe, good morning, boys. Oh, it's not the
best. Hi, how are you guys?
Good, man. How about yourself?
Awesome.
Good. Good. So it looks like over here, we ended up, we would have gotten close to 1-1 over here, about 9 pips. Our stop loss is at 11, and we came right back down to break even. So those of you that aren't in here, guys, we aren't in this. This is just a paper trade since the range is so small. We're just seeing how this is working out over here. So since it's a paper trade, I'll just put it off like that. Your 5-minute candle closed with no top wick. Let this be a lesson for all the time frames. Happens a lot. Where you get a strong close like that with no top wick, this candle ends up pushing up, right? And then we just end up rejecting. Happens a lot. I'm not saying this is going to completely reverse. I'm just saying, you know, I see these two candles following each other, you know, quite often. This candle could create a top wick and then flip bearish coming right back down here. This is why we kind of stay out of these ranges on a Friday. Let's go back to GJ, see how we're looking over here. Yeah, still a mess. Steve, I'm guessing you didn't take anything?
No, I just came to the charts.
All right, cool.
I was looking this morning on the GJ, but from my phone, I couldn't be at my laptop, so I just analyzed and that's it.
Yeah, it's not looking too good anyway. You're good.
Yeah, it's rangy.
Yeah.
Although GA, I was looking at it, it's kind of reversing back down on higher time frame. It's kind of going for a retest of the trend line below.
Okay. Let's take a look. GA or GU?
GA. Okay. I mean, I'm just watching because GJ is boring, so yeah. I need to occupy myself with something.
Is the Australian dollar a little bit stronger right now? Maybe because they've been increasing rates?
Yeah, if you draw that trend line, just move it below the current low. The one you had, the smaller one.
Smaller, yeah, just right here?
Connect those, yeah, from the, yeah. Connect those lows.
So you're saying we're bouncing off that and also this support right here.
Yeah, but probably we're going to retest that trend line again before the bounce back
off. Continuing up. Okay, so right now we're in a sticky zone right here where we need price to break out of either side.
Yeah.
Let's see. The current weekly has been bearish all week. The daily is currently bearish. We ended up grabbing liquidity, coming back up into this range, and then flipping bearish over here. So I could see us, you know, not really paying too much mind to this trend line. And we just need to close below the support to then continue right back down. So we have a very heavy bearish week, right? Been bearish all week. Yesterday was a little bit bullish, kind of correcting part of the move, retesting, and then continuing right back down. Let's look at the 4-hour. So the 4-hour is holding a resistance right here. Right? Holding a strong resistance. We ended up closing below the market structure right here. And also retesting and passing the low of that candle. By the looks of this candle, Stipe, you would know better than I do. Did this candle pass the low of this right away? And then form the top wick? And then flip bearish again?
I didn't see that.
Okay.
I actually didn't analyze the 4-hour. I was looking at 1-hour. And 1-hour is constantly bearish. So since since London Open.
Okay. Yeah, this is probably a range I would wait for price to break out of either side. Right? Wait for price to break out of that resistance. Unless we form like a solid support right over here with this trend line, and you wait for something like this, let's zoom in a little bit. This is like the lower time frames. You wait for kind of like what we were just talking about with gold. You wait for a little, you know, for it to get a little bit higher if it does, and then come right back down to form a higher low, and then continue right back up. So see if it holds support here and even another support, like a higher support for you to take this right back up. How much volume does this pair have? Wow, we have about 50 pips in this range. So this is definitely something that you can get. The only thing is, you know, we've been bearish all week. And you'd be going against a trend. You think Friday we're going to correct the whole move? Obviously not the whole move, but right now we're in a interesting situation right over here. Meeting up with that trend line, meeting up with that previous support, but also in a bearish trend. Could we be reversing and you know, retapping 185 up here?
Go back to...
So gold ended up rejecting. That's why this was a... this was a paper trade. Now this candle could very well come down and hold that higher low like what we were just talking about and then create like a nice support to then continue right back up. It looks like we retested right over here with this candle, but there was not enough range in this or not enough pips in this range for us to grab a move. It's only about 20 pips right here. And your stop loss would have been around, I don't know, 16 below this candle. So you want to be careful when it comes to your stop losses with gold. It's very sticky. Just came in here. We got Miles. We got Jaden. What's up, boys?
What's going on, man?
How are you?
Pretty good. How are you, bro?
Good. Yeah, we're just taking a look at gold over here. It's we were looking at we took a paper trade over here as the 15-minute candle created a bottom wick, retested this area over here, and then flipped bullish. But even more important, let's look at why we're looking at this level in the first place, since we got most of you guys in here now. Obviously, we've had these higher lows or lower lows, lower highs on gold over here. We've reacted to this level that we talked about yesterday, right? Multiple rejections over here, especially with this candle. This candle ended up rejecting and closing below that level over here. This candle created a top wick, flipped bearish, passed the low of this candle right here, closed a strong bearish candle below market structure. This candle retested that market structure, flipped bearish, passed the low of that candle, and came down into this area over here and tapped exactly where this wick is, right there. So looking at the lower time frames, the 4 hour now, 4 hour, you have this whole zone over here, this wick, all these wicks in here, and then price reacting to this area over here. You don't have to draw your zone like this. Miles, was it you that was talking about this? Or was that Tiffany?
Yeah.
It was you.
Yeah, okay. No.
So as you can see, sometimes there is a great opportunity for you to draw something like that. And it honestly keeps you out of dumb trades, you know, where you think price is going to continue right through a zone like this on a Friday. If you just have this here, you know that it needs to get through a lot for that to happen. And you need some clean price action up here that you know that price could, you know, once we get some volume, price could push through that. But right now on a Friday, I don't know if that's going to happen. But nonetheless, on the four hour, we are printing these lower highs within and lower lows within this bearish trend over here as well. But now, obviously, we've approached this level of 1770 over here, psychological level, and now we're pretty bullish. So I was saying, could we be coming up into this area over here to create a resistance, another lower high, to then continue right back through here? It could happen. But when we were looking at the lower time frames, again, this is a very strong level. Price is bouncing off of. What I wanted was, you know, we had a little consolidation here on the lower time frames, a close above it, and a clean retest to take this right back up. So when we were talking about that, here we go, previous support, now current was a resistance as well. We broke through it with this candle. This candle created a bottom wick and then passed the high of that candle and shot right up, right? So when we were talking about waiting for this candle being bearish at the time, waiting for like a bearish close and then a bullish close right here, you could possibly take this thing up. But it was an impulse. It ended up having to be an impulse entry if we were to take it. So this candle created a bottom wick. We got some good volume, passed the high of that candle right over there. So we paper traded it. I said, okay, this could probably come up to this level up here and end up rejecting. But the problem is, would you have your stop loss right there? Would you have your stop loss a little close, like right there? Probably for an impulse entry, yeah. But, you know, with gold, you could very well come back, snap right back, and take you right out. And that's something that you got to look out for. But again, this really wouldn't have made too much sense on a Friday trying to squeeze this little move out. It did push up about 9 pips based on my entry. So would have pushed up 9 pips. I may have missed the secure because I would have been waiting for 10, and it would have came right back down to my entry at break even where I would have closed 50. Or even the full thing, knowing that price is, you know, in this sticky range. Now, the good thing is this 15-minute candle hasn't created a top wick yet. But the thing is, the previous or the current 30-minute candle already created that move. And now we trace a little bit, creating like a doji. But again, if you were to take this, it needs to be clean because it's a Friday and you're going against the trend. Only reason I like this was because we're bouncing off a zone like this. So we could very well end up getting a fake out over here. Price closing right back down into this area over here. And then we could continue right back through. I would just be careful. GJ as well. GJ is a mess over here. We got terrible GDP coming out. We had all these numbers were basically red, right? So obviously not a good sign for Great Britain, according to their economic activity and production. So it didn't really move GJ too much, right? The current daily candle is bullish. We created this bottom wick, and now we're flipping bullish over here. So that shows 149 is a very strong level. Also 149,600, remember this from yesterday? Now we're starting to push up again. These candles got a little bit weaker, but do not underestimate this area right here because we've rejected multiple times. We need to clear this area to continue right back up. Once we clear this area and close above it, we know that we could grab a nice intraday or a swing trade coming right back up. Now, these numbers over here are going to go a long way when it comes to monetary policy for Great Britain. They see the numbers aren't good enough yet. You know, GDP is not too good. Also, they're going into like a plan B lockdown. I'm not too sure what that means, but Boris Johnson just announced it yesterday. So with that being said, there's no economic activity. It's hard for them to taper or increase interest rates when it comes to that. They need to see stronger numbers for that to happen. So it's looking more and more likely that they're going to be waiting for February for that to happen. With that said, we could end up ranging over here, holding this support over here, or we could end up just breaking right through. So the weekly candle is going to close a strong bullish candle right here. This is exactly what we said when we made this move up from 149. On Monday, we made this move on Monday coming all the way up, right? So we said that, you know, it could only move so much. Now it's starting to retrace. We could end up consolidating throughout the entire week and end up closing like this. Who remembers me saying that for like 2 days in a row? So that's what we're going to get. This is exactly what we want. A nice, strong, bullish candle on the weekly. Now, could the next candle create a bottom wick? We stay in this range a little bit on Sunday or Monday, and then it starts flipping bullish to then start filling this wick and continuing right back up. Based on the technicals over here, and this being a demand zone for people to get in on the pound to continue right back up. multiple times this has happened. Oh, is the music loud? Jaden? Was that it? It's like so intense. Yeah, it's my concentrating playlist. I just put that on a back test. Thanks for saying something. No one else wanted to say anything?
I was digging it.
Am I gonna kick it just
randomly
out?
Started. It just randomly got loud and started overpowering your voice.
Do you know what that's from?
No.
You ever see Interstellar?
Matthew
McConaughey?
Yes.
It's the best space movie. But it has, do you know who Hans Zimmer is? Any of you guys?
Yeah, I've heard of him.
Yeah, he's a beast when it comes to like composing for movies, doing the scores for movies. He's done the Dark Knight movies, basically every Christopher Nolan movie, Inception, Interstellar, Dark Knight. He actually did Lion King, you know, back in the 90s. There's a lot that he's done, but like listen to his music when either you're working out or just like back testing, chilling on your computer, getting work done, just keeps you in the zone. It's funny though. Starts blaring. So that's what we're looking for on GJ over here. We ended up creating these highs up here, right? Created this high, ended up retracing, and the weekly candle ended up coming right back down to here with this being the wick, right? This was the candle body where price currently was, and now we're starting to continue right back up. Don't expect any real moves today. I wouldn't try to squeeze anything out of GJ. I think I would just let it stay put. And if you need to get your fix, I know a lot of you guys like the trade. You like the action. I think all of us do. Hop over to the simulator. Start simulating a little bit. Get your fix that way. That's what I used to do. When we would be trading with like Raquel on their live streams, and you know, there's nothing much going on throughout the day, I'd be on the other screen or on my laptop or something like that, just back testing on the simulator. And then during COVID, you know, after the stream, I'd be getting another 3 or 4 sessions in, since COVID, you know, kept us in our house for months. We are holding this support over here, which is nice. And we're holding the support that we talked about yesterday, 149,600. We ended up holding this. I don't think no one's still in GJ, are they?
I'm not.
All right, good. So I want to take this off. Now, while we're waiting over here, looks like we're going to get a bearish close over here on the 15 minute. While we're waiting over here for any kind of move, I don't even know if we're waiting for a move. We're just going to break down a few more trades over here. But I wanted to point out real quick, I pointed out to a couple of you guys yesterday, the amount of detail that some of you guys are putting into these. Like, I love it. This is what's going to get you better. Like, this one from Miles, like, look at this. I mean, he put his AAR basically and his trading journal all in one. Like, he put this all on Trello, which is cool. So, like, Miles, you put all your psychology stuff on here, it looks like.
Mm-hmm.
Is there anything that you write on the side?
No, to be honest, I haven't gotten in the habit of doing any other AAR. So, no, like, this was basically just what I do just for my trading, because I noticed that I just wanted to have, like, capture my psychology as well. So, yeah, this is just, like, strictly my trading journal.
I'm not saying that you should. I was just wondering if you had anything else. But this is perfect. This is everything that you want. Maybe start implementing, like, an end-of-day AAR that you do start writing stuff down and you start critiquing your day to see how much you've gotten out of your day. You know, it's like a diary, like a girl, you know. You're just basically just writing down your thoughts. What did I do today? Was I making the right decisions all day? Could it have been better? How could it have been better? Stuff like that. If you start implementing that, try doing that next week. You're going to see a massive change in your attitude, the way that, you know, how productive you are every single day, how much you're getting done every single day, because you're holding yourself accountable.
Mm-hmm.
So doing something like that, you know, in a notebook like this and writing your goals down, all that stuff. You know, I talk about that in the course and how to use one of these. Very powerful. Looks like gold over here starting to flip bullish over here. Again, this is counter trend trading. We already just rejected this area over here. This could have been the little move, but we never did break the low over here. And this is the 15 minute. Again, it's a small range for gold. And I just don't want to force anything. so anyway, just a great, did you see my comment, Miles?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I reviewed it. Makes sense.
So yeah, if you guys want to take a look, I know we did break this one down yesterday, but we'll do it one more time over here.
I added a more recent one too that I lost. If you wanted to check that one out as well.
You added what?
I added another trade, a more recent one, I think, that I took yesterday.
Perfect.
So we can check that out too if you want.
Yeah, absolutely. That's what this is all for. So this is the 4 hour. This is the highest time frame that you took a picture of. Yes.
Yeah.
So also, like, if you want to start adding the daily and the weekly, that'll be good for you as well. The more detail, the better. The more things you add to this, the better. It can't hurt, right? So obviously the 4 hour over here, it looks like we're holding a resistance, reacting to this previous support over here, waiting for close below bullish trend line, ended up taking impulse entry after top wick rejection. Entry number one, 150.316. So somewhere up here.
That was, yeah, I definitely wrote that. That's the wrong, I don't know where.
Wrong price.
Yeah, wrong price. I probably was looking at MetaTrader, and maybe that's where I got stopped out or something. But no, both my entries were pretty much around the exact same level, the 150.065 level.
Okay. Perfect. Let me just move this over a little bit. Just want to give us the most screen we can. Perfect. So entry number two, this looks a little bit more realistic. 150.065. So right here. Gave second chance after stopped out, 1%. Okay, cool. So we got that top wick formed past the low of that candle right over there. Okay. So now you have this rejection over here. Now this candle, would you entered as we passed the low over here?
Yeah, I entered based on the 1 hour. Okay. Yeah, exactly. After the top wick was formed and we passed the low of that candle as well as the previous two for the 1 hour.
Okay. Being that this is the 30 minute, I definitely see what you were doing. Do you enter this based on the 1 hour or the 30 minute?
The entry was based on the 1 hour. And I think my stop loss was based on the 30, but like, yeah, the catalyst for my entry was based on the 1 hour. I also have a screenshot that says 1 hour entry catalyst there just to remind me.
Oh, cool. Perfect. Wow, it's my elbow. So me personally, I probably would have waited for a close below this market structure right here. I see what you were doing as we broke the low, but we could have very well rejected this level. Also, this candle closed with no bottom wick. So again, you could go 50-50, get a clean move to the left, maybe wait for a nice little retest right here to take this down. But so far, I like it. So you ended up entering on this candle, right?
Yeah, it would have been that candle, I believe. Yes.
Oh, okay. So what ended up happening right here when price came right back up and passed the high of that candle?
So
after reacting to this support.
Yeah. So what? Oh, you mean after the trade?
Well, no. So you entered as this candle ended up passing the low of that candle, which was probably the 30 minute, or was this the new candle?
Let me see here. That was the to be honest with you, the I think the 15 minute I just used mostly to take the screenshots. I didn't use it to analyze my entry at all. I'm trying to actually stay away from the 15 minute for now until I can get more consistent with the 30. So yeah, the 15 I didn't use it for an entry catalyst at all. It was just to capture more data after the entry.
Okay, perfect. So with that being said, this was probably your entry candle as we broke the low of this one, because you didn't have to sit through this drawdown, right? Where price passed the high.
Yeah, no, I didn't.
Okay. So yeah, so this was the entry right over here. Just keep that in mind, something that you could write down, like always put the end of this or the beginning of this P&L tool right exactly where you entered on the candle, or like if it was an impulse entry, like as it passed the low, or you know, right at the candle open. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm.
It just makes it easier for you, and you can move it throughout the time frames. So the top, we got the top wick rejection. Keep this in mind. I actually just pointed this out before you guys all got on to Gary and Carlos. But when you get that close below this support right over here, right? We got the close below, but there's no bottom wick. And when you get no bottom wick, a lot of times this candle ends up passing the low right away, and you get a hard rejection. Right, that's very common where you get that hard rejection. So you want to wait for, if you get a close like this below, let's say you didn't take the trade yet and you're waiting for a close below the support over here, right? You're waiting for this close below, you end up getting a candle like this. Okay, I'm going to stay out for a second, right? I'm going to wait for a nice little retest over here and candles closing in my direction on the lower time frames over here, like a bearish candle like that. Okay, now we know that we could take this thing down and mirror these candles. I mean, trading is all about patience and being able to wait for this stuff. If you miss trades, you miss trades, but at least you're not losing anything. And there's, you know, as you go through your journey, you're going to be missing less and less trades because you're going to be more and more used to seeing more and more setups. Again, we haven't even hopped on our second Zoom yet, but when we put that trading plan together, we start with one or two setups, right? And as you work throughout your trading career and as you gain experience, you start to realize that there's more and more setups that you could be taking. You see it once. Okay, you take note of it. Oh, wow, I see this setup again. Cool. This is making sense now. Oh, wow, I see it a third time. All right, next time I see this setup, I'm going to be entering this. I'll enter a low risk, right? Now I can start adding this into my trading plan. And as, like I said, as you go through, you get more and more setups in your toolbox, if you will, and you could start taking a lot more trades. I'm not saying like take five or six in a session, but I'm saying like you'll have more opportunity to enter trades because you see more setups and you have more setups in that expertise of yours. That makes sense?
Yep, it's kind of like the counters, like in that Bernard King video. It's just like getting more counters as you train longer, basically.
Yeah, man, that's a great point. Yeah, so Dave, this is David's chart over here. I love the chart. I love the breakdown over here. So this is very similar to what Gary sent in as well. We're just looking for price to break this level over here. If we break support, it's still a little tricky, but we definitely should be coming down to 149,600, right? If we break and close below the support, maybe even retest, we should be coming right back down into this level, right? Especially after reacting to this level. But I wouldn't trade in here. This is a big no-no right in here. And then you got your trade zones right up here. You got a clean move right here to the left that you could be trading in. This gets a little harder to trade in because it's so choppy, but we should be dropping down into that area. Again, I don't think that's going to happen tonight, right? Especially with the weekly candle closing the way it is. We did get negative fundamentals. That's why everything is kind of just consolidating. Nothing's really like moving. The weekly candle is going to close a bullish candle like that. Could we fill the wick on that candle and continue up? So I think this is the main bias right over here rather than breaking below. But we'll see because we are in a bearish trend still, right? We're trading what we see, not what we think. So you're waiting for some of these consolidations to break. You see that we're in the bearish trend. You're waiting for the bearish trends to break, and you get more and more confidence that price is going to continue up. Awesome, David. It's great detail too. Love these charts when you guys send them. It's how you get better. So yeah, there's not much volume in gold right now. It's just kind of figuring out what it wants to do. That's why you don't force it. So back to Miles's trade. There you go. So how'd you manage risk over here, and how could you have done it better?
I have it written in my notes, but basically what I did was I think for this one, I actually had my full stop loss hit, and how I could have managed it better was definitely closing. I could have closed 50% once I saw how that 30 minute closed and the 30 minute high was broken. I could have closed 50%. I actually could have, in this case, I probably actually could have closed even more, seeing how the maybe like 70%, just seeing how the 30 minute close with no bottom wick. I think that would have been a good opportunity to close even more, to be honest.
Yep. We actually have a good example of that with my trade yesterday, which I actually added to the group journal as well. I haven't finished. No, I sent the first one. I haven't finished this one because I had to hop on a Zoom with someone last night. But if you take a look, the reason why, like this is the trade from yesterday. We got the bearish movement. We keep rejecting 150-500, right? We're pushing down over here. This is the 4 hour. We know that we have this area that we need to pay attention to. Previous support, 150-600, I think it was. This is the like zoomed out 1 hour so that we see the area to the left. This is the zoomed in 1 hour. So we get bearish price action. This was that move that we should have gotten around 6 o'clock yesterday morning. But you know, nonetheless, we still got part of the move. So we knew that this 600 level was very strong based on what we just saw to the left, right? So we knew that price could be reacting to that level. But what we did was we saw the lower lows being created. We see that price failed to break below 600 right over here. We did it multiple times over here, but we ended up closing right above. Then we ended up rejecting it one more time and then grabbing liquidity again. We created this lower high over here. Created this lower high over here on the 5 minute, respecting the bearish trend, right? Then we get the liquidity coming in, passing this, or not liquidity, we get the volume pushing in. This is the 5 minute time frame as well. I took this base on the 5 minute, broke the low of these candles with the volume, 7:30, 7:45, 8 o'clock. We know we're getting good volume at that point. So price ended up pushing below, and that's where we entered the impulse entry. Now, the reason I bring this trade up, Miles, is because this candle, if you take a look, see how this 5 minute candle ended up closing with no bottom wick?
Mm-hmm.
So every time frame's the same. Only difference is the amount of data that's in each candle. You know, how strong is each candle? So this candle entered the impulse entry. It ended up closing like that. So automatically, I'm a little cautious. I'm like, okay, what could be happening with this trade? At this point, I'm only like 2 pips in profit. So I'm not going to do too much yet. I know that when you get a close like that, most of the time, the next candle ends up maybe creating a small top wick, but then passing the low like right away. But then what happens right after that? Once it passes the low, ends up rejecting that area and continuing right back up. So instead of like securing like 80% right here and move my stops to break even, knowing that that could happen, what did I do? I just closed the full thing right here at 5.2 pips, I think. Yeah, 5.2 pips. Closed the full thing. I was content with it. A little jab at the market. That's all you need. Let's zoom out and see what happened after that. So we ended up breaking all the way back down to 149,500, maybe like 4 or 5 pips more. And look at that. I was in the middle of my journal when I had to hop on that Zoom. So we'll take a look at the actual price action, and I'll finish that later. So here you go, 149,600 right here. This is that move. This is the entry right here. ended up breaking right back down to 500 and then rejecting and continuing right back up. But you see that how that works when you get that candle closed with no bottom wick? It could be 50-50. This could very well have dropped, passed through 500 and continued down, but it didn't. And you can only pay so much attention to the 5 minute, but it helps. And that's why I ended up securing the full thing right here instead of securing. Right. GJ's reacting to that resistance, that 200 level we talked about. Still in this no trade zone. Anybody looking at anything else before I continue with this group trello that you want broken down or? Yeah, absolutely, Gary. Miles. So yeah, this hit your full stop loss up here. And what I would have done was I would have remained cautious right over here when this candle closed with no bottom wick. I wouldn't have closed anything at this point, Miles, but what I would have done is maybe secure a little bit once price makes this push right here and then starts retracing right back up a little bit or starts flipping bullish. That's where I would have secured a little piece of it. Knowing that after you get that close, especially on the 30-minute time frame, get a close with no bottom wick, this candle starts coming right back to the close of that candle, you know that we're going to get a hard rejection.
Gotcha.
You're not going to get a nice little retest and then continuing right back down. That doesn't happen as often as it does retracing, especially because we're in a bullish trend. This could just be a fake out to continue right back up.
So yeah, that makes sense.
Something for you to go right back into here, like a later analysis or something, you know, somewhere down here and just write that down. Like, this is maybe what I would have done differently. But constantly having your foot on the pedal like that and constantly looking at what you could have done better is what's going to get you much better. It's hard at first. It's frustrating at first because you keep having all these errors. But over time, and it happens quick. I was actually just talking to Catherine last night about this because Catherine, she just joined our group as well. So we got another girl in here, guys. I was explaining to her how everything just kind of like clicks really fast. And it's just like sports. Miles, obviously you play sports. So, you know, when a team is first coming together, you got a bunch of rookies, let's say, and they're all working together on one system, trying to learn that system, quarterbacks on the same page, running backs on the same page. But you have all these difficulties going throughout the beginning of a season. But then when the defense starts to like make sense of everything, the offense starts to click a little bit, everything just happens quick and you just start winning 2, 3, 4 games in a row where everything's starting to go for you. So it's the same exact thing with trading where, you know, you everything meets up as far as your eyes being trained, seeing a lot of these setups and being trained with that, your risk management, you get that under control where you know exactly that you can trust yourself with closing trades that are losing trades. When price is going in the drawdown, you're not hesitating at all. Where you can trust yourself to close 50 or close the full thing and just get right out and live to see another day, live to see another trade. When that starts to click with the expertise, with the experience, with the trust of yourself, everything starts to click and it happens quick. But keep doing this, keep staying detailed and disciplined with this stuff, and it'll start to turn. But this is awesome, dude. Keep this up.
Will do.
All right. So we'll go into James's trade over here. This is actually very similar. I think this might be the same trade. Hold on. I reviewed these the other day, so. Looks like he took this on the 6th. Wait, Miles, I think you put the 11th right here, no?
Yeah, I definitely put the wrong date. I think that was supposed to be the 6th.
Wait, so this was Monday, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
That was Monday.
I'll just change it for you.
Thank you.
Yep. Yeah, Monday the 6th. So James, I think, took the same thing. Sounds good, Gary. Okay, so not as much detail as Miles over here, but yeah, very same setup over here. This is what he took. So it took entries at the break of the low, stops at 10 pips. Okay, so we got to see it on this time frame. Okay, so he took, I think, the same trade that we took on Monday. Yeah, this is the same trade that we took. This is perfect. So this candle, as you can see, Miles, we ended up closing below. That's it. Then you get that bullish close. Also, don't forget to take after pictures, like what happened after that trade. That'll be like your last picture in the journal. Make sense?
Mm-hmm.
So we ended up grabbing liquidity up here, but then canceling that whole candle out with a strong bearish candle, right? When that candle closes at a support like that, all you want to do is wait for that top wick to form and it to pass the low of the previous. You put your stop loss somewhere around here. Perfect stop loss placement. Give himself some room. Doesn't have to be exactly on top of that candle. And let it just drop right over here. Most of the time, this is going to drop and mirror some of the candles to the left. But again, in an uptrend over here, you want to be careful. You want to close like full. You want to close 90% once you get that volume push. Right? So this was nice. Secure 80% at 13 pips. Looks like he didn't move his stop loss to break even. Took entry. Okay, stopped at break even. He was stopped at break even. Most of the time, I like to move this thing down, but it doesn't matter. But it's a great little scalp. 13 pips, secured, stops at break even. That's it. You guys got to keep in mind, most of your runners will not succeed. Most of them will get stopped at break even. But that's okay. This is another James trade. So this is a trade that I think he was trying to call bottoms on over here. This was a trade that we were looking at, and we were saying we're going to wait for price to break above that resistance to take this, right? Now, if you're going to take this, you need to wait for a close above this level, if anything. And even still, this whole range right here is only about 10 pips. So is this something you really want to take when you see all these wicks over here, all this mess? You're also in this range over here. Just it's a whole mess over here. So you want to wait for like a break and a retest of this if you had like 25 pips in this range, but you didn't. So he was trying to call bottoms right over here, where this candle ended up rejecting this level right over here and then flipping bullish. And he just entered that blindly, thinking that we were going to correct that whole move. Look how bearish we just were. Right? What makes you think that price is going to just completely reverse and continue right back up? I get it. Price is bouncing off this demand zone. But again, you need to wait for market structure. You need to wait for, you know, some kind of like consolidation in here. Okay, price ends up breaking the consolidation and then retesting over here. And then, okay, this is our move. We know for sure, like 80, 90% chance that this is going to play out. If you wait for that retest and wait for the close above market structure, above the order block. But again, like, look at all this. Something to stay out of. But how did he manage risk? Entry. Close full as price came close to the stop loss below previous wick. Okay. So he ended up basically getting the stop loss close or hit. Which it's good that he was able to close 50, but I think when this candle passed the high of that candle, that's where he was entering, right? And then once it started to flip bearish, I would have closed 50 or the full thing right here, because I would have realized that I shouldn't be in this trade. I need price at least closing above this level right here. Make sense, guys?
Yep. Makes sense.
Cool. But this is why we send these trades into the group channel, just so that we can review them. You guys all get better by looking at other people's charts. You see different setups. You're like, oh, wow, okay. That would have made sense. All right, maybe he shouldn't have done that. So now I'll keep that in mind so that I don't do it, right? A lot of labels over here. I like it.
And I think – sorry, so I was just going to say, I noticed – I was just had to check my journal just then because that trade that James entered looked really familiar. And I was like, I think I took – I thought I took that trade, but it's actually – that's the post-analysis that I did on my my trade that I took on Monday. So that same trade that he ended up taking, mm-hmm. that's the one I noticed afterwards that that could have been a good trade for me. So I had that journal in the Monday journal too.
If you guys have any analyzed trades, you guys know what I mean by analyzed. You could put them in here, right? Don't be shy of putting trades that you didn't actually take, but make sure you label it that you didn't take it. You know, that you learn from those as well. And it's good to add those into here so that people can learn as well. Like, okay, what was he actually thinking? What should he have done? What does he wish he took? Right? Everyone can learn from those too. So good win and a bad loss. I'm guessing these are two trades.
Actually three trades.
Buys and sells.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. So again, great detail. Oh my God. See this? It's what you want. Takes a long time. But guess what? When you tell yourself that you have to journal every single trade, you think he wants to do this for every single trade if he takes five trades a session? No. he doesn't want to do this for any more than two, I'm sure, right?
Sorry, say that one more time. I didn't hear the last
one. I was saying, like, to everyone else, like, do you think Miles wants to do this for five trades that he takes in a session? If he tells himself, I need to journal every single trade that I take. If you need to journal every single trade that you take, you're not going to be taking five, six trades a session. You're only going to be taking one or two. This journaling also stops you from overtrading. Because you know that, all right, I need to journal all my trades. Do I want to do all this work for five, six different trades in one session? No. Actually, you took two trades in here, but nevertheless, trade one. Okay, cool. 30-minute entry. So you took this as it started breaking above, right over here?
Yeah, let me see here. Yeah, so basically, as you can see on the right there, I would entertain buys if I saw a strong bottom look rejection, followed by a break of previous 1 hour high and break out of 30 minute. Basically, what happened is just when it got close to the one to seeing that 30 minute close, I got too excited and took an impulse entry instead of waiting for the actual close.
Okay. Okay. So I was just looking at gold. Gold's breaking up a little bit. But again, don't get FOMO. It's a very small range. So you took this without it closing above. You just kind of got impatient a little bit.
Yeah, that happened to me a couple times this week. So I'm implementing some stuff in my plan to change that. But yeah, that's what happened in this trade for sure.
All right, David, I'll see you later, buddy. Nice to see you. So okay, that makes sense. Get this hard rejection right over here. Bottom wick created past the high of that candle over there. Again, you probably want to wait for the close above. Previous 2 4-hour candles are bearish as well. Okay, so we're breaking up a little bit. Oh, okay. So now how'd you make full stop loss hit? See? While you were journaling?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. That's what happened.
So that'll teach you a little lesson. Stuff like that happens all the time. Like, especially like, like we'll be not so much like managing a trade because I pay close attention to my trades. But like when I'm breaking a chart down and then on one of our pairs, we have a setup about to take place. Sometimes I miss it because I'm doing that and I need to constantly remind myself writing in my AAR. Listen, pay attention to the chart at the same time that you're breaking down other charts for other people. because you're going to miss some of these trades. And that's happened a couple of times. So you just keep reminding yourself not to do that, not to let that happen. And you go forth and keep writing it down. You don't make the same mistake twice or multiple times. So right over here, where, you know, since it stopped you out at your original stop because you weren't paying attention, what would you have done instead, like as far as managing risk?
I think, I probably wrote it, I may have written it down, but just looking at it, that's the thing I'm trying to figure out, to be honest, is like, I know for me, like, I know I've tried when I completely get out of trades, before letting my full stop loss hit, I know for me, sometimes it doesn't work all that well for me, because I can start, you know, thinking about, just wanting to at least see the trade play out. So for me, what I've tried to implement is just when I want to take risk off the table, is just using percentages. So leaving my full stop loss, leaving my full TP. And like, if I want to get out, then take like 75% off the table, or take 80% off the table to reduce my risk that way. In this instance, I didn't look at the 5 minute, and I am trying to stay away from the 5 minute for right now. But that, I'm sure if I did drop down to the 5 minute, I probably could have seen some early signs that, were rejecting that, that area. And that could have been used, or even, looking at the 30, I think, or I guess also the 15 here, barely had a top wick. So that's another thing I could have used, is looking at the following 15 after it broke the high and started coming down below my entry. And it looked like it's probably going to respect that trend line. And that little mini 15 minute was just a fake out. Probably could have easily closed like 50% there, mm-hmm. at least. And then cut that down.
When you took this trade, after you entered the trade, did you realize that you should have waited for a close above, or was that never a thought?
You know, I did. I know after I entered, I did realize that I should have waited for a close above. And then basically what allowed me to, or in my mind, you know, what justified me staying in the trade was that I got the 15 minute close, even though I know, like, in hindsight, obviously a 15 minute close isn't that strong, especially if it's in a counter trend trade. And that's not what I was waiting for. I was waiting for a 30 minute close, but yeah, while I was in the trade, that's how I justified staying in it, was seeing that the 15 minute close above that trend line.
Okay. So, like, I'm just thinking, like, let's say I entered this and I realized that I should have waited for that close. What I would have done is I would have saw this starting to push up. It reacted to this level right here. I wouldn't have acted right away, but as soon as we reacted to that level and we started flipping bearish and started coming right below this level, right at this point right here, that's where I would have probably either closed 50 or closed the full thing, knowing that, you know, we could definitely be coming down and stopping us out. But also, like, I shouldn't have been in this trade because I should have waited for that close above. Plus, we're in a messy range on the higher time frames as well. Mm-hmm. Like there's areas to the left that's just all messy. So, you know, with that in mind and the fact that I shouldn't have been in this, I would have probably either closed the full thing or closed 50, like right there at that point, as soon as it flipped bearish like that. Whenever you feel like you just shouldn't be in the trade, just exit. And I know it's very hard. You know, my mentors would tell me that all the time. Raquel, Ted, they would all say, always close the full thing when you know you shouldn't be in the trade. That was very difficult for me. Even somebody that was very high on discipline from the very beginning. I just didn't want to do it. I just wanted to see it play out. Now, it's very easy for me to just close the full thing, because you're concentrating more on capital preservation instead of capital appreciation. Instead of making money, you're concentrating on saving money. Now, I know that sounds like you're not going to be making too much money doing that. Trust me, it's the only way to trade successfully. If you concentrate on saving your money and keeping your money more than you are of making it, you're going to make a lot more. And you're going to keep a lot more, and you're going to be a successful, confident trader. Eventually, you'll be able to trust yourself that you're securing that risk, or you're closing early and you're not hesitating. And that's where you can start increasing lot size, when you can trust yourself doing that. Does that make sense to you guys?
Yeah, that makes sense to me.
It's all like a hidden cycle that people really just don't even realize. But once you realize it and you keep writing it down, you keep telling yourself, keep promising yourself that you are going to close full or close 50 when price goes into drawdown. Now, it can go into drawdown and you be okay with it. There's certain setups like that. There's certain, you know, trades that sometimes will go into drawdown and you're not gonna close 50. You're not gonna close the full thing because you know it's playing out. You know it's still playing out in your favor. That's kind of micromanaging. You don't want to do that. But at the same time, it's very hard to explain it. That's why, like, I'm constantly trying to bring these trades up, my trades up. You know, when we're in the live market, I'm showing you exactly what I'm talking about. But there are some trades where you're not going to be micromanaging. You're just going to be watching them. But it's okay that it's going into drawdown a little bit. And I'm sure some of you guys know exactly what I'm talking about. So, again, great journal, Miles. Love it. Oh, wait, you took multiple trades over here. Okay, so that ended up getting stopped out. Grabbing liquidity, continuing down. Okay, so you entered. Where was your stop loss on this one, Miles?
On that one, my stop loss was above the current. Oh, sorry, what time frame is this? Is this the 30? Yeah, so on this one, I think my stop loss was above the current. I think it was above the current 30 minute, I believe. I can double. What was the entry there? 153.79. Let me actually just double check.
379. Right. Let's see if you have
So my stop loss was. It doesn't even say on here. I think it was above the current 30 minute, I believe.
Okay.
Actually, can I see that? Yeah. Can I see the hourly actually on that? If it should be there.
It's the 4 hour and it goes right to the 30 minute.
Okay. Yeah. So it would have been above. It would have been above the current 30 then. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. It makes sense. Like somewhere around here.
Yeah.
Or even closer could have been. Just didn't create that top wick and it passed the low right away, which, mm-hmm. you know, is good. We could definitely tap into that area, but then we could also just reject. And there you go. You got that rejection. But this is good. You close 100% as 4 hour consolidation support was rejected. Perfect. So you close the full thing right here?
Yep.
Okay. Now, do you wish you did anything differently?
No, not in this trade. No, I was completely fine with where I closed it. Though actually, if anything, I think I wrote down in my description there. I think something that I could have done is knowing that that was a strong zone. It definitely could have been a trade where I just closed 100% once the full TP was hit, or once I got close to the full TP, because it's not like I knew that there wasn't a big chance of it running. So that could have been a good opportunity to just close 100% when I was happy with my TP being hit, as opposed to holding any longer. But yeah, overall that's kind of me nitpicking, but overall I was pretty happy with how I managed that trade.
Oh, wait a minute. So when you took this, it ended up hitting your take profit, then rejecting, and then you secured up here?
Yes, I think so. Okay. Yeah.
All right. So this is a good spot right here that you're going to be securing. You don't have to let it hit your full TP. You could cancel the TP and secure 80% when it hits your TP. This is beautiful. And then stop loss at break even. Let it hit you at break even.
Yeah.
But like if it hits your TP like that and your full target, you got to secure at least part of that.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Because again, it's a little messy on some of the higher time frames. This has been a difficult trade, difficult week to trade, but we've been managing and we've been doing really well. No one's taking any stupid trades unless you guys are doing it secretly. Everyone's managing risk. we're getting the trades that we could be getting throughout the week, but it's been a rangy week. It's been very difficult to trade. So everyone's been doing pretty well with it. It's just there's a couple lessons to learn, and you bring that into next week. Take that over to the weekend. You review your journal again. You can do a full week review where you back test the whole week again, right? Stuff like that. And that's how you get better. So, again, another great journal from Miles. Let's see if we have any more. Yeah, I think you have that one more, right? We broke down all these yesterday. All right, so this was a psychological mistake, huh?
Yeah, definitely.
FOMO, over-leveraged, over-traded, poor risk management. Nice. At least you're honest with yourself, right?
Yeah, I have to be.
This is good. Absolutely. Got to have thick skin in this.
I just took a trade on gold on 1 hour, but I closed everything at 6 pips since I didn't want to keep it longer. It's kind of nice to rain, but...
Beautiful. So you grabbed the. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
No. Sorry. What did you want to ask?
No, I was just confirming that you grabbed 6 pips out of it and you closed the full thing.
Yeah. The full. I left 0.01 just to see what's going to happen, and it's currently at 13 pips, but it's okay.
You're risk free.
Risk free. Yeah.
I like it. The fact that you were able to do that. And then just close the full thing and be like, all right, I just grabbed what I wanted out of the market. I know that unemployment is coming out in 20 minutes. I'm just going to be content with this. It's a Friday. I'm done. I'm happy with that. So that's good. That's good work.
I closed everything now.
That's beautiful. Doesn't that feel good? Like getting in a trade and then knowing that you could trust yourself to get right out and you're good.
Yeah.
It's the best.
This was really quick. 13 pips. Let's be honest.
That's what being a scalper is.
Yeah,
you're grabbing quick little jabs out of the market. Now sometimes go ahead.
Yeah, sorry. No, sorry.
We keep cutting each other.
I interrupted you. No, you were speaking.
No, I was just saying, like you know, sometimes we grab those longer moves as well, intraday swing trades. But most of the time, like especially in a market the way we've had the past week or two, you know, it's good to grab these little quick jabs, quick moves. A little bit harder to trade, but nevertheless, we can handle it and just close the full thing, close most of it, and just be content with the trade that you take.
Yeah, I remember when. Okay, I'm kind of. I forgot the word. It's not the right thing for me. No, just say when you're done.
I'll let you talk. I'm not gonna. I'm done talking. I'll let you think about it.
I can talk a lot.
No, that was my fault. I kept cutting you off.
No, it's okay. We have time.
So where was your entry?
I entered just before the flip on 1 hour because. Those last 1 hour close very, very strong.
Yes.
And we had a kind of rejection down there from the zone. And I was kind of just scrolling through my mind. And I remembered when you were speaking, I think 2 or 3 months ago, when you were talking with Ted and he told you that sometimes he has, I don't know, 20 pip stop for 7 or 8 pip take profit or something like that. So I just wanted to try to take, let's say, 4, 5, 6 pips. And I kind of just did the trade like that. So just take that impulse and get out with anything.
Yeah.
Even this trade would really be nice because my entry was at 1773.5. So now it would be about 22 pips if I left it whole, but it's okay.
Yeah. I mean, again, great work. When you're trading at something like this on the 4 hour, right? Everything is just sideways on the 4 hour. When you're trading also counter trend on the 4 hour, it's a great move that what you just did. You know, you were bouncing off a heavy area where this wick came right back into that area. We rejected this area multiple times over here. right? And then we just approached it over here. You get some bullish price action, clean 1 hour candles, right? You grab your quick jab out of the market before the unemployment comes out, and you're golden.
Yeah.
And now you're happy with yourself.
Yeah, definitely.
You're proud of the way you traded. And that's the question that you want to ask yourself every single session. Am I proud of the decisions I made in the market and what I did, how I conducted myself, how I managed risk, how I secured, all that stuff. It's a difficult game, guys. As you guys know, you guys all know it. And the more you do this stuff, it's going to click.
Also, on the other side, this is 2 hour candle, which is NY open. So 4 out of 5 days in a week, there's at least 20 pip push on that candle.
Wait,
on the opening, sorry, in the first 15 minutes. That's what I realized. So maybe I'm right, I'm wrong.
Can you go back to that? I didn't hear that first part. What do you normally notice?
Oh, this 2 hour candle. Oh, sorry, it's my time zone. The NY open, it's 8 a.m. candle, your time.
8 a.m. candle, okay.
Yeah, there's almost 4 out of 5 days that candle pushes at least 20 pips in one direction, at least.
It's a great point.
Here, it created a wick, which was almost as big as the previous 1 hour candle. So let's say 3/4 of it. And then it started flipping back. So I said, why not try this thing? And looking back to, if you can switch to 2 hour time frame.
Yes.
And see how clean it is actually. On 1 hour, it's pretty choppy, especially this morning and Asian session. Mm-hmm. If you switch back to 2 hours, it's much cleaner.
Yep.
So
yeah, very clean on the 2 hour. All these previous candles are.
Yeah, that's why I kind of more often in the last couple of weeks mentioned those 2 hour candles, but I don't know. I just see much cleaner than 4 hour is a pretty long period to trade and to look at things. And 2 hour is kind of somewhere in between.
I like the 2 hour. I don't really use it too much. I used to use it a little bit. Someone brought it to my attention one time and started implementing it a little bit, but I don't know. I've focused so much on the daily 4 hour, 1 hour, 30 minute, 15 minute. I ended up getting rid of the 2 hour, but it does make sense. Now, again, this is an awesome trade. None of you guys should really be getting too much FOMO from this either, because first of all, it's a counter trend trade. And this is something that you could perfectly start to just journal it and learn from it so that you guys can catch it down the road more. Like right now, this is just something that it's perfect. Like, okay, I could have grabbed this morning. I didn't grab it. Okay, but now we can start paying attention to this for the next time this presents itself and maybe take it that time. But we're getting some heavy push before unemployment coming out in 14 minutes. Or no, not why do I keep saying unemployment? CPI. Unemployment was yesterday.
CPI, yeah.
Why do I keep saying that?
There's a lot of news this and next week.
Oh, yeah. A lot of stats next week. Could break this down if you guys want.
So when does usually the holiday break start for most people?
Not till like the 23rd, I would say.
Yeah, because I've seen that 24th is the day before Christmas. I forgot how they call it in English. So
Christmas.
Day before Christmas.
Oh, Christmas Eve?
Christmas Eve, yeah.
Yes.
So that's the first day of the holidays. And I think it's Friday, right?
This yep. Is.
So the 4 days, I've seen that there are also news at the 23rd. So I was thinking like, okay, we're going to trade until Christmas Eve.
We'll probably finish it on the 22nd or 23rd over here. I'm sure the 23rd will go till Thursday, and then we'll give ourselves that next week, the week after. You got New Year's Eve, which is on Saturday. That's pretty awesome. And then you got the whole week after that, and then Sunday the 9th. Oh, what is this? Oh, here we go. Yeah, January, Sunday the 9th right here is when we're going to pick right back up. We'll do a full market breakdown. We, you know, refresh each other. And also during this week or these 2 weeks over here, we're going to be doing like backtesting sessions, reviewing trades, stuff like that, reviewing journals, hopping on one-on-one Zoom, stuff like that. We're not going to be completely off. It's just good to not be trading in the market because you got institutions, banks, big investors, big time investors, movers of the market. They're all on vacation. They're all taking time off. You know, I know traders that trade maybe 2 months out of the year and then they're done for the rest of the year, which is pretty insane. I think I sent that video into Slack.
Yeah, the interview with those two guys.
Those two guys, right? Those guys take off like months at a time.
One of them said, yeah, that he, when he met his kind of goals in terms of percentage or profit, he takes off the rest of the year.
Yeah. So this is videos in the video channel. If you guys want to watch this, it's a cool little discussion that they talk about. It's like a podcast on a doc, and they're just talking about some of their secrets to trading, what they think about the market, stuff like that. Good thing to watch.
This would have been a nice trade if I held it.
Certainly is it. Yeah, it certainly is a nice 8 a.m. candle. That's something that Stipe, you can write down. And when you journal that trade, journal what it looks like after. So that maybe you hold that on, you know, hold on to that for a little bit longer.
Yeah, but I don't know how I didn't see it. On 30 minutes, we have so clean area on the left side. And this 30 minutes, the previous 30 minute candle closed at the tops. If you switch back to gold on 30 minutes.
The 30-minute candles?
Yeah.
Basically corrected this entire candle.
Yeah.
It did correct that whole candle.
This one here closed kind of this.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. Sorry. I'm going to clear it up. So the zone you marked. Just a second. This zone here you marked. This when this kind of 30 minute before the current one closed, it closed near the highs, and when it broke above, maybe this week was only problematic thing, but everything on the left was kind of clean 35 40 pips.
Yeah
it was the trend you drove there.
Yep. Yeah, I figured we would get like another tap of this area. We could very well get a fake out over here and price closes right back into here, and you know you could take price right back down to 1770.
That might be a fake out for the news.
Yeah we'll see how news reacts to CPI. Now what's interesting over here is that they're expecting better CPI, like prices to come down a little bit, which is good. Like normally, you know, higher than expected is normally better. But right now in this inflationary time, you want it below what the previous was. Now, they're expecting below right over here. But for some reason, it alarmed me that Biden was saying, now they're saying it surged to a new record in November. Well, Biden was saying that the current CPI numbers are not going to reflect some of the decreases in gas and energy that we've been having over the past week or two. So that tells me that he probably already knows an idea of what the number is, and that it might be still high. So we'll see. But we are getting that tap of that trend line over here. We'll see if we get a fake out. If that's the case, it could probably take price right back down. But don't trade the news. Trade the reaction to the news.
Let's see today before the news. How's gonna 1 minute? The last 1 minute can close.
Hey, what?
You remember what we were speaking about news when I mentioned that before the news, that I noticed that the last 1 minute candle, so the one starting at let's say 29, how it closes, then the news most often continues in that direction.
That's a great point. Yeah, we'll go down to the 1 minute around 8:29 and see what it looks like. It is hard rejection.
This is a huge drop.
Yeah. So obviously you could have squeezed some more pips out of it, but at the same time you're getting a hard rejection. You may have been stopped at a break even right now. You entered on the flip of this candle.
Yeah.
Oh no, that's the 15 minute. So you're getting close. It
completely turned back, yeah.
Jaden, how you doing, buddy?
Pretty good. How are you?
Good, man. How was that NFT drop?
It was crazy.
Yeah. What goes on with that? They give out NFTs or?
What
do they do with that? Like, what does that drop?
They have a lot of different things going on with that company. They got a couple of video games they're coming out with. They got, so there's 10,000 pieces that were that dropped, and they didn't actually drop the drop. As soon as the countdown stopped, it said sold out immediately, and everybody started freaking out. And I guess the server crashed, and so they postponed it till 1 p.m. your time.
Okay.
But they've got a lot of crazy things going on. Snoop Dogg is and Amber Rose and Ezekiel Elliott and a bunch of other celebrities have shouted them out already.
Wow. Snoop Dogg's like pretty big in this space, huh?
Yeah.
He's doing a lot of stuff. You didn't like my little joke in the Cryptos channel?
I didn't see it.
Oh. Read this. Peter liked that one. I said it doesn't make corrections, it dumps. What did he say? A shitcoin. So. Hard rejection. Let's see if this 1 hour candle closes. Actually, the 30 minute candle closes like this. This will be interesting. And also, keep in mind the 4 hour candle is going to close in 30 minutes. Damn, look at this.
GA also strongly rejected the area when you were looking at it, and now it's going all the way up. GA.
Yep. What was our analysis over here? We were saying that we could react to this area?
Or that area or the trend line.
Yeah, oh yeah, that's right. We were saying this is kind of like a no trade range. But what do we get? A hard rejection over here?
Is that the same zone which is at these tops here?
Not quite. From here it is.
Oh, yeah.
So price kind of bouncing off that level. All right, Miles, have a great great weekend, dude, and I'll see you probably Sunday. What I'm looking to do is do a backtesting session this weekend, and also hopefully Sharma will be available for a breakdown on Sunday as well. So get those two things done.
Sounds good. Did you still want to meet today, or did you want to meet?
Yeah, What time do we decide on?
I don't think we scheduled anything, to be honest. Maybe unless you message me, let me see.
Hold on, let me go into our messages. Yeah, reach that to the schedule. Oh, okay. Yeah, let's see what time today. I have a bunch of time today until about 4 o'clock. Let me just double check. Actually, make that more like 345. I can't do so. Let's aim for 12 o'clock noon. How's that sound?
Yeah, that works for me.
Is this good for you? All right, let me just put this in the calendar. I type in miles and it autocorrects to Kyle's. All right, Friday, we'll do 12 noon. Perfect. All right, brother.
We'll see all right, you cool. All right, man. You guys have a great day.
You too, buddy. Good. All right. Hold on. We got to get gold real quick. Got to go to the 1 minute.
Hey, bro. Austin Lewis's signals are on sale if you're interested.
I'm sorry. What was it?
I said Austin Lewis's signals are on sale if you're interested.
Oh, my God. Should we jump on that? Signals from Austin Lewis.
Dude, 90% accuracy on US 30.
Wow. Because that's totally heard of.
Right.
So, yeah, looks like the Stipe, you looking at gold?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the 1 minute over here.
Yeah, it usually flips in the last 10 seconds. So.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised.
Let's see what's going to happen.
Should we get the second chart on here? 1 second. The 5 second chart. There we go. All
right, yep, I was right.
Yes, you were.
And I didn't enter this, but it's okay.
And what?
I didn't enter into this.
Oh, good.
I expected this thing to happen.
You're learning. We could take our time coming over to...
I'm so pissed I canceled my buy limit.
What's up?
I'm so pissed I canceled my buy limit right before that.
Did you? 0.8.
I saw how fast it was falling. I was like, I don't really like it. And then I closed it.
This was just grabbing liquidity to head right back up. Yeah, it was 0.8. I'm surprised. Like I said, I was taking my time coming over to Forex Factory because it takes so long to release the data. Core CPI came out same as expected. Regular CPI came out higher. Let's see if there's any let's see what we got here. Increased 0.8% in November. On a seasonally adjusted basis, after rising 0.9% in October, the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics reported today, over the last 12 months, the all items index increased 6.8% before seasonal adjustment. Wow. So, broad increases. Let's put indexes. Yeah, so gasoline, shelter, food, used cars, trucks, and new vehicles are all among the large contributors to rising prices. Okay. Yeah, obviously gasoline's rising, homes, rent rising, food, you see it in the grocery stores rising, used cars and trucks, we're having a chip shortage. Obviously, we need to be making more chips over here, and then new vehicles altogether. The energy index rose 3.5% in November as the gasoline index increased 6.1%. And the other major indexes, or energy components indexes, also rose. Food rose by 0.7%. At the index for food at home rose 0.8%. Not good. All right, Carlos left us. Cool. Crazy, man. Bad policy. Entry. You got in?
I got my entry. I'm at 30. 40 pips right now.
Wow. Good for you, man.
Closing everything. Close everything, yeah.
Good shit. I love that. Dude, you seem like so much more disciplined right now with that. Yeah. Over the last like week, I would say, right?
Whoa. Yep. Damn.
See, you could have secured this one full position or like most of the position, gone break even and just let it run.
Yeah, I could.
But again, that's just something that you write down. You grab 30, 40 pips. You grabbed 13 before that or 6 before that. So I would just be happy. You're 2-0 today. I would just close the chart and be like, all right, I can't watch this anymore.
Yeah, I closed my magic key, so that's enough for me.
Love it. Great job, buddy.
Thanks.
So now we're starting to approach this level up here again around, 1784 to 1788. This whole area, we're starting to retrace that right here and retest it right up here after tapping into this area. We're coming right back up. So we're in this major range over here. It's a bitch.
This would be a nice 80 pip trade.
Yes, it would have. GJ's still struggling to get above this area. Let's see if we get that close above and we get a retest to continue right back up. I don't know if I want to trade this. I think I'm done for the week. I'm pretty happy with the way I traded this week. So I may just be done for the day, especially because we're approaching this consolidation area. The 1 hour. Yeah, it's approaching a mess over there. And then plus, I think what happened was the weekly pushed all the way up, created this top wick. We retraced a little bit, and now we're going to start to recover over here a little bit and then close in this area. So I wouldn't try to squeeze too much out of GJ anymore. I don't think it's going to move much more. But guys, with that said, guys, have a great day. Great weekend. Sunday, like I said, I'm looking forward to doing a backtesting session and a full breakdown for the week. And then if you guys need any one-on-one Zooms, please reach out to me and we'll get it done. All right, boys.
What about the Zoom we talked about? You free later?
Stipe, what time did we say we were going to do that?
After the stream, so it's up to you.
Okay, Let me what's it called? Let me make a quick breakfast and then we'll hop right on.
Sure. Just keep me up on Slack.
Okay, yeah, absolutely.
See you later.
All right, boys. Have a good one, all right?
Yep. Bye, guys.
Bye, guys.